Scott here with CategoryOneGames.com, and what we have for you today is an interesting collection we just got in. Our friends at Mesa Comics in Mesa, Arizona contacted us and said, hey, we just got in a collection of Magic cards, and it came with extra stuff, and we really have no need for it. We're a game store, we're a comic shop, we don't carry these other games that we got as part of it. He said there's Star Wars, Star Trek in there, some Lord of the Rings, so he said, hey, let me send this up to you, let me know what you think about it. So this is our video review of it. So we'd like to, first off, give props to them. Mesa Comics, if you're down in Mesa, Arizona, check them out. Let's take a look and see what we got inside. You'll notice I'm wearing gloves. I always do. Keeps the card safe, protects them. Make sure that I'm not getting anything on them that would be bad for the card. Keeps them in the right condition. All right, first off, we got a rare right there. It's not a great rare, but it is a rare. So we're going to set it aside. This will be our common stack. Let's float through these and see what we come across. All right, Kwai, we like to see that. Hidden base. Zuckster and Ship. Oh, Lord Vader. That's always nice. Oh, hey now. That's what we like to see. Ewok Catapult. Even though this is just a common or uncommon, I'm not even sure, from Endor, I'm actually in need of these. So I'm going to set that aside as a special one. The rest of these commons and uncommons, they're going to just go in our bulk lots of commons and uncommons where you can buy them. All right, set those aside. Ewok Catapult. Alright, let's see what else we got in here. A lot of commons and uncommons. Dagobah, Cloud City. These ones are backwards. Sniper. We'll set that aside. We're always needing those. Funny, we actually need prepared defenses. We sell a lot of those. And so, anytime I get them in, I always set them aside. Let's see what else we got in here. It'd be nice if we found some more of those Luke Skywalker Jedi Knights, right? Alright. So, Panaka, AI, Luke's lightsabers. These are all rares right here. This must be the stack of rares. Going through some premier rares. All right. Specific or special modifications, not a rare. Vader, white border, still sells. Sells really well. All right, let's see what else. Whoa, that's a shiny card. That's a young Jedi back. I don't know what that's off of, but that's interesting. We'll set that aside. Ooh, look at this. This is a... Alright, we got a bit of a SIM card error there. So, picking up where it left off. I just found these foil versions of cards. Somebody printed them out with foil paper. Stuck it on a normal card. Try to make it look cool. That's not something I'm really into. That's probably going to hit the trash for me. Some people might find those interesting, but I really only care about the cards that are really in the game. Alright, so let's keep going through. Ooh, look at this Death Star. This thing is bent all up. So if you're looking for a heavily played, conditioned Death Star, it's going to be 20% of the normal price. Boom, right there, it's coming for you. Alright, let's keep going through. New Hope, some Veers. Hey, General Veers, I'll always take those. General Veers are one of the top selling cards for Hoth, really good. Same with Jedi Love, love that card. Visage of the Empire. Or sorry, Emperor, not Empire. Mind What You've Learned, always does with Daughter Skywalker. Let's see what else we got. Hunt Down, always a good card to get in stock. Vader's lightsaber, Tarkin's, Fett, Luke's. Hey, anybody need some Luke's? We got them. We're going to have them in stock soon. Choke Vader D-Lots. All right. That's what we like to see. So turning out to be a pretty good collection. And here's the interesting thing, we actually haven't even paid for this yet. He sent it to us and said, hey, go through it, let us know what you think it's worth. And so we're going to have to pay these guys at Mesa Comics a pretty fair amount here for the cards they sent, because they sent some really good stuff. Let's see what else we got here. Obviously the person they got it from that played Magic, must have been a pretty good player himself of Star Wars. Kind of curious to know who it was now in the Arizona area that traded this in. So that would be kind of curious to see or find out. Mon Mothma's, Endor Operations. Ooh, here we go, some Coruscant. Always good to see that. Tauntaun Bones, is it common or uncommon? Just going through, looking at the cards. these random Dagobah cards, like polarized negative power cufflings, hiding in the garage, they always seem to sell well. I mean, they're not expensive cards at all. They're usually under 50 cents, but they always sell really well. Let's see, we got a stack here laying down. Sorry about the mess, we'll put that aside. Sniper we'll put aside. Sense we'll leave in the stack to go. All right, so here's some more rares. Ooh. Ender Operations, always like seeing those. Jotocast, all good cards. Oh, I'm seeing some Young Jedi. That's where you know the fun ends, right, guys? All right, Mary Jade, or Mara Jade. I used to always call her Mara, and I started playing with some other players. They're like, no, it's Mara. And I'm like, what? It's Mara. Well, turns out it's Mara. I said it wrong for years. All right, here's some Young Jedi winners. Ooh, some foily arsing scoundrels. Not just a few, but a lot. Oh, another one from, I think that's Reflections, if I'm not mistaken. So this is a decent, look at this. So if you're into Young Jedi, this is kind of the mother load of Young Jedi. So downside is, if you're interested in these Young Jedi, I've got to get through grading all of the Star Wars cards before I get to Young Jedi. We'll put the commons, uncommons aside for it, and then just pull out the rares or foils. And you can tell Young Jedi rares because they have a star down here at the bottom. It's a common or uncommon. One's kind of a triangle shape, and I can't remember what the other shape is. Sights actually don't come with any symbol for rarity because they were only inserted in starter decks. And so they're star deck exclusives. And that makes them usually harder to get and a little more valuable, surprisingly, because not everybody wanted to open starters just to get a couple sights. Look at all these foils. I mean, this is, I don't know Young Jedi pricing off the top of my head like I know Star Wars. Well, I'm guessing there's some decent cards in here. And if you're a big Young Jedi collector, contact me. We'll work out something. Okay, here's one of the symbols right here. You can't see that. It looks a little different than the star, obviously. So we'll have these Young Jedi. We won't grade them just yet. So if you're interested in them, give me just contact me through YouTube, Facebook, Twitter. You can follow us on any of those to get an update on when they actually post to the site. You can also contact us directly at scott@category1games.com. Alright, obviously there's good stuff. I mean, if Young Jedi was still being played and was a popular game, I would think this would be pretty cool stuff. I'm guessing the foils like this, we have another one here that's Young Jedi. I'm guessing that's just a card that has had, that's a foil card that someone has stripped, would be my guess. Alright, let's see what else. Some Bulbas, more sights. Man, this is probably worth a lot if you counted Young Jedi at full price and there was high demand for it. Obviously, whoever this was must have played the game and must have been really into it. Either that or, I don't know what, had a good contact with the Cypher and was getting a lot of these sent to him. Who knows? Because obviously there's some good stuff here. And then it's good stuff and foils, and then randomly we get to commons and uncommons. Okay, we're almost done with this box. We got a box and a half left here. See what's in those. I'm willing to bet there's some other interesting things in it. Alright, so this is from the later set. A little icon there. And this is from the last set. Unta Eve Pod Race. So obviously those usually are a little more sought after. Last sets in a card game are usually a little more desired because they're underprinted. Players have usually left by then and will want to come back eventually to finish off their collections. There's a few different reasons for that. Oh, hey, look. Another Luke Skywalker Jedi Knight. There's two in there now. All right. That's what we like to see. All right. Next thing. So we're going to put this box away. Go on to our next box. Let's go with the little one. See what's in here. Alright, we got some Lord of the Rings. And so far all we're seeing is commons and uncommons. Let's see if this eventually turns into rares. gives us something good. Alright, here's some rares or promos. Rare. Okay, so we're definitely picking up some rares, so that's good. Set the commons and uncommons aside. Let's hope this stack right here is all just rares. That'd be nice. Okay, rare. It's always nice to see all these rares in Lord of the Rings. A lot from the earlier sets, though, which are usually more common to get. Here's some international cards. Some more, and of course that's a rare, so it's nice to see international, foreign language that are rares, and not just commons or uncommons. Desperate Defense of the Ring, that's cool. That's really cool looking. Orc Bowman. Whew. Morgul Gates, those used to be hot cards. Alright, obviously a lot of Desperate Defense of the Rings in there. There's four right there. Play set, if you will. Let's see. Tower Assassin. Oh, didn't mean to do that. Stack all backwards. Flip them. I wonder if they're all set one and set two or something. How they had that set up. Alright, set three it looks like. Let's hope they go beyond the first three sets and actually get to something a little more valuable. I haven't seen any real big mains like a Legolas, which is funny because Legolas is only about a $2 card now. So saying it's a main is just kind of a funny thing. But there are cards. I mean, Swarms always does well. There's two of them right there. Four of them. Armory. A Promise. Good cards. More foreign language. Like more of a Hunter. You know, this guy that played, obviously, and this was his collection, he obviously was a Decipher fanboy, if you will. Like many of us that are probably watching this video, you probably collected a lot of the Decipher era items. So this should all look pretty familiar to you. Nice, thin, and stretched. International. I should stop saying international, it's foreign language. Ooh, Elrons, those will always do well. Aragorn, Heir of the White City, Witch Kings. Cave Trolls, those look nice. Some foilies, we get to the foil part. Everybody seems to have foils in the game. Another Cave Troll, but that's in Tangwar. That's not all that hard to find. All right, not a bad haul for Lord of the Rings, a decent amount of stuff. I'd say our stacks are getting pretty big here of usable items versus non-usable and some value. Alright, so let's open up the last thing here. This is our last box. Let's start at the back and see what we come up with. Ooh, hey now. This is a little out of the ordinary. Some Dragon Ball Z. This game just recently got reintroduced as a living card game. And all of the older cards are now playable within it. I don't know anything about this game. I've got a local player here who helps me out with games that I don't know. He was a big Dragon Ball Z player. He's my buddy that we play Raw Deal, WWE Raw Deal. He'll probably be able to help me with these or know if there's anything of value. I mean, there's a lot of foils. I mean, that's kind of cool, but I have no idea if any of those are like, you know, quarter, $15, what they are. So obviously I'm not gonna spend too much time on that, on Dragon Ball Z, because simply I don't know much about it. Alright, some more DBZ, some Versus, Verse System, this looks like Marvel Verse Origins, original set, this Clobber in Time was a cool card. Alright, back to Star Wars, put that aside, that's a premium. Hey, Jabba's Palace, everybody needs more of that, right? There's a premium. Some of the sites from Special Edition, here's more locations, operatives. Everybody wants more operatives, right? Speeder Bike, Light Side. Not as big a seller as Dark Side. Dark Side is almost impossible to keep in. Let's see here. Let's keep going. The back side of it. See if we can't. Oh, Explosive Charges. Those things sell out super quick. Speeder Bike. Let's see here. Vantage is rare. Protector's rare. A little stack of Cloud City rares. Weapon Lab, Slave 1. I mean, none of those are really valuable, but I mean, they sell well. People buy them. People want them. Let's not tiff over our stacks here. In general, you know, it appears most of these cards are probably in played condition for the most part. I mean, there's nothing that... I'll have to take a look at those Jedi Lukes, but like when you have a bunch of Cloud City rares, you know, it's not worth a lot of time to go through and grade them all unless you look at them right away. You can see how perfect they look. These ones definitely don't look that way. All right, I guess I'll hold on to Master Destroyers there, but I'm not going to hold on to Captain Tarpole. So let's see what else we got. Dark Descension, Maul Saber, those are rares. Tatooine, Space Lug, Jedi Lab. Alright, so another card error, so we had to change it over. And now we're back looking at this. Dagobah. Oh, here's some Coruscant. Some sights for Coruscant. I can always use those. Put that aside. Okay, Battle Planes. Those always sell well. Remember, all these cards are going to be on category1games.com. We're buying them from Mesa Comics, and we're going to grade them, and then we're going to put them all in Category 1 Games. So if you see something in here that you're just dying for, that you see it, and you're like, man, I got to get that card, we're going to get it on the site. Don't you worry. Some of them might take longer than others because of the need and kind of everything else we have going on. But we're going to try to get everything on as quickly as possible. Get these cards available for you to purchase. I mean, these are definitely cards that people want. We had a great sale over Thanksgiving, Black Friday. And now we're just trying to basically catch back up and restock as quickly as we can because of how much we moved. And so this is going to be a great help for helping with that and getting that restock in place. Obviously, this is Jabba's. Not a lot here that's worth much. I mean, there's your two money cards, basically, from Jabba's. I guess you could say the Sail Barge Passenger deck has become more popular lately. Not really sure if there's a deck floating it or running it quite a bit, but I've noticed sales of it have been going up, and it's been harder to keep in stock. All right, at least we got two right there. So that's good. More Jabba's. Hey, there's a Rogue Bantha in Japanese. Alright, so commons, uncommons. Alright, Death Star 2 sights. Ooh, here's some Death Star 2 ships. We always need those. Death Star 2 always does well for us. It's probably our number one selling set as far as cards that move. We can never keep it in stock, so whenever we get it, we're really excited for it. And it just means these cards are going to be available for you. So make sure you stop on by here probably next week or so. And either we've already got them on by the time this video plays, or we're working on it. So, come on by and take a look. Let's see. Some of these Endor rares are just hard to remember if they're rare or not. Like, especially the guys. Like, Averick is not rare, but Drelison is. So it's just kind of interesting. All right, Karita and Endor, we'll always keep those. They always do well. All right, we're near the end of our box here. Getting down to the last little bit. Okay, closed door. We'll keep the Endor. We'll leave the Biker Scout gear for you guys to get in a Commons Uncommons box from us. Let's see here. And if you might see something I miss, and that might be just, whoever gets that box, they're going to get that extra rare, you know, card that you need. Insurrection, we're actually almost out of those, so we got to hold on to those. Rack is a rare. Lieutenant Greave is a rare. Flip these over, it looks like it flipped on me. Sergeant Whalen, rare. We're actually out of Paplus, so hey, there's a restock of them. Flank isn't rare. But it's a card that sells well, so I'm holding on to that. Man, they're throwing some stuff at me here. What's rare, what isn't? I can't remember offhand. I'm going to put him in the rare stack. If he's not, we'll just take him out. Not a big deal. Throw me another charge. those sell well. You rebel scum. That's always one of my fun, a fun card to say and see. Alright. Some more rebel scum, well-earned command. Oh, here's some reflections. Two premiums. And then we get a random Dagobah. And special, oh, we are running low on all power to weapons. We'll hold on to those. Cammies are rare. That's rare. Imperial City always sells well. Dantooine. Hold on to that. X-Wing Cannon. We hold on to those. B-Wings. We hold on to those. TIE Laser Cannon. We'll hold on to that. Storm. Snow. What is that? Sand Trooper. We'll hold on to that. Nope. Rares, rares, rares. Not a rare. I always think this guy's rare. He's not. There, this guy looks like he should be rare. He's not. Alright, two more stacks to go through. Let's get through them. Commons and uncommons, commons and uncommons. Oh, rare, randomly. Stay sharp. I'll flip these so you guys can see them. They're net. Like I said, sometimes cards get past me, but I've been doing this a long time, so generally I know what one is going to be your rares. Rare, rescue the princess objective. Ooh, he always gets me. He's not rare. Routier, operations, crate dragon. This deal's getting worse all the time. Ooh, I hope we have some Jabba's Palace premiums. Just a few. Sorry, those are Cloud City premiums. Gotta get my premiums right. Obsidian and Black Squadron ties. Look at this stack of rares. I mean, that's doing pretty good, right? For Star Wars. Alright, Dark Collaboration rare. Light Repeating Blaster. Dantooine is not a rare. Neither are those cards. Okay, Whiteboard Premiere. They always stick together. Ah, it's so annoying. That's rare. Rare, rare. Rare, rare. Rare. Rare, 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 rare. Don't you love going through Whiteboarder Premiere where you see some of these and you're like, is that even worth the time to go through? And I totally agree. I often wonder that. But you know what? People like them. The game is loved by collectors and players. So you know what? You can't hold that against anybody. Somebody's going to want it at some time or another. Alright, here's that backside of premiums we were looking at earlier. So, always need profit. You can either profit by this or be destroyed. Those always do well. Alright, that is our stacks here of cards. Kind of an interesting find. Again, this is a collection from Mesa Comics. Let's see if I can't bend this a little bit so you can see what else we got. So this is our stack of commons and uncommons. You've got your young Jedi foils and then commons and uncommons. I mean, there's some decent stuff here. We got to figure out a value. We got to work it out with Mesa Comics now. And then once we do, all this stuff is going to get graded and go on Category 1 games. So you can find all this soon. Check us out.